All right, hello Internet. Welcome back to our web tutorial on Azure ML. So last time I showed you guys how to create an experiment and import data from a local file. And today I'm actually going to teach you how to read data from an external source. So last time I showed you how to import the Titanic dataset, right? So we just drag it in. So that was an example of reading from a static data source, something that you saved on your local hard drive. But if you remember correctly, we got that data from an external website, right? So you can actually have Azure ML read that directly from the link itself. So go to data input and output, and in that you'll find a module called the reader module. All right, so just drag that in. The reader module is actually pretty flexible for what it can do and the amount of inputs it will take in. So it'll take a bunch of inputs from a variety of sources. So an external link is represented as this HTTP link right here. So you select HTTP, and I'm just going to go to an external website that hosts a number of data sets, right? So the Titanic just happens to be one of these data sets. So I'm just going to copy the CSV link. So I'll go back to my reader module and just paste it into the URL once I've selected HTTP. And yes, it is a CSV file. And yes, the CSV does have headers in it. After you've done all that, this actually doesn't contain any data inside of it yet. It's still just an empty module. You will actually have to run the model down here for it to actually read and parse the data. You don't have to do this right now, but it's just good practice to check to see if your data is actually there before you start doing stuff with your data. So I'm gonna hit the run. And what's gonna happen now is a timer is gonna appear in the module. That means the cloud is working and it's processing and it's parsing your data from the external source. So you can tell that it's done by the check mark next to the module, and you can actually see what's inside, a quick preview of what's inside. Okay, so the data got parsed into the module. That's really cool. And that was how to read from an external link. Now, this is really cool, right? Because if tomorrow the data change, you can just hit run again tomorrow and it will read tomorrow's data. So if you have ever-changing data, if your data is dynamic and it's continuing to change, you can continue to update your model and it won't affect the rest of your experiment. It will continue to flow through the rest of the experiment in the normal workflows as if, it was the same data. Now, it can support a bunch of other things too. So that was the HTTP. So let's just select this module, Control C to copy it, and then Control V to paste it. Now we have another reader module, right? So this one was reading the data from the external link. Now this will actually support a bunch of other things as well. So for example, you can do a Hive query. All right, Hadoop supports Hadoop. A Power Query, or you can read from a SQL Azure table. So you can literally start typing in SQL, right? So I'm just gonna do a quick demonstration. So select column from table where date like today, right? So that will get you, for example, the sales data from today. Now, what if you want to compare it, with yesterday's data, right? So just copy and paste it and then just say yesterday, right? So now you have two back-to-back data files reading two separate SQL tables. I would recommend adding a caption to your reader module just so that it's very clear. So just double click on it and label what it is. Say today's merchandise sales data, right? And then an arrow should appear that you can close or open and it will tell you what the label is. And now you could do this for all modules, not just for the reader. Here's another quick example of what the reader can do. So here is a reader that's reading from a Titanic dataset that we've backed up to the Azure Blob Storage. So it is backed up securely in the cloud. So if you want to share this securely or back it up securely and not have it be an open HTTP link, you would just upload it to the Azure Blob Storage and then read it from the Azure Blob Storage. And at any time you have a dataset that's populated via the reader module, you can simply just click Save as Dataset on the node, and it will actually just show up over in the datasets area. And that concludes the tour on how to read data from an external source as well as the reader module. Join us next time where I will show you how to do data exploration and data visualization using the tools present within Azure ML.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.